Welcome back to my channel. In today's episode, we will continue talking about monobenzone and will clarify some of the confusions, such as what is the difference between monobenzone and benoquin, why it is so difficult to get a prescription for monobenzone, and explore some controversies about this chemical. So let's dive in. What is the difference between monobenzone and benoquin? Many people are confused when they search for monobenzone on the internet and social media because some people call it benoquin. Now, the difference is quite simple. Benoquin was the brand name for the first ever drug which contained monobenzone. So monobenzone is the name of the active ingredient and benoquin is the brand name. The USA FDA approved this drug in 1952 for the treatment of extensive vitiligo. The patent was applied by a company called ICN Pharmaceuticals, who started their business by applying a lot of innovative dermatological related patents in 1950s. Now, ICN Pharmaceuticals later became a huge company with multi-billion dollar turnover because of the discovery of some widely successful antiviral drugs. The sale of benoquin was not even a drop of water in the ocean of money that they were making. And they ultimately dropped the benoquin from their portfolio due to lack of sufficient demand from dermatologists and patients. Suddenly, there was a vacuum in the global supply for this drug, and the demand was filled by the compounding pharmacies who started compounding monobenzone in-house in 20 to 40% strength as per the instructions from the dermatologists, who were still prescribing this cream for eligible patients. Nowadays, the drug has become generic, and any pharmaceutical firm can apply in their country for the same formula as the original benoquin with a different name and can start manufacturing this cream. One company in India even registered exactly the same name, benoquin, and is now the most common brand available on the internet. The demand for this drug is still extremely low, and many small, genuine pharmaceutical companies close the production of this cream once they realize that they cannot make any decent money out of it. The reason for low demand is basically quite obvious. Dermatologists do not like to prescribe this to even patients with extensive vitiligo. Why is it so difficult to get a prescription for monobenzone, even for people with extensive vitiligo? In my opinion, the truth is that the repigmentation treatment is far more financially lucrative for dermatologist clinic and often requires several months of therapies, which means a steady flow of income and repeat business for hospitals and clinics. Prescribing monobenzone to a patient would mean they have failed and given up their repigmentation efforts. It would also mean that once the patient starts on Depig therapy, they do not need repeat visits to the clinic and can finish their treatment at home. It is also possible that the dermatologist has no prior experience with depigmentation. And since ICN stopped the production of the drug in early 2000, it is not possible to get it from your regular pharmacies, and it is also usually not covered under your insurance. Then there is one more thing. With monobenzone, the process of depigmentation is not very predictable and cannot be easily controlled. Some people would depig under 6 months with no complications, while others would drag on for 2 years or even more, and some would get complications midway, such as repig spots due to sun exposure or hormonal changes. So you can understand that they are hesitant to write you a prescription for the drug. Why is it controversial and banned in some countries? This has a lot to do with the craze of skin lightening in some societies. There are people who would do anything to lay their hands on the strongest skin lightener product that they can find online or in their local pharmacies. They often misuse hydroquinone and other related products which have a skin lightening effect. Since monobenzone is one of the strongest in that family, it is also commonly misused for skin lightening by some people. These people often are uneducated in the actual knowledge of how monobenzone works and often end up inducing chemical vitiligo in their bodies. What they don't understand is that there is a multi-billion dollar cosmetic industry doing dermatological research, and this cheap chemical is openly available since 1938. If this was such a magical potion for the normal skin pigmentation problems, don't you think it would have been already used in cosmetics by now? There's a reason that it is not used in cosmetics, because it is not a skin lightener for normal skin. Now, the governments cannot change people's mindset, but they can definitely ban products which they think are the root of the problem. Hence, many skin bleaching products, including monobenzone and some of the hydroquinone related products, are banned in many countries nowadays. However, this creates problem for people like us who genuinely need monobenzone for the full body depigmentation therapy for their vitiligo. This problem is not going to go away soon, and you will just have to hope that your country's border controls don't make it too much noise about your small order of some tubes, especially if you're ordering monobenzone from a company outside your country. I hope you like this video. Don't forget to check out the next video in this series. If you're new to my channel, do not forget to subscribe and share the videos to people who you think would be interested in this topic. Ciao.